for more on what all this means for investors, we're joined from Boston by Ken Talbs. He's the Chief Investment Officer at Pioneer Investments. Pioneer manages a total of $255 billion worldwide, with $67 billion in the U.S. Talbs also is the lead portfolio manager on the four-star fund, Pioneer Strategic Income Fund, which has over $4.5 billion in assets and beat 91% of its peers in 2010. So we want to make sure we get that performance in, Ken. Now, when you hear the breaking news that you just heard from Peter, saying that even the Democratic proposal now is running into some math problems or math issues, for you, does that make you more nervous about what's going on?
Well, frankly, you wouldn't expect AAA credits to be behaving this way, although we've seen this in the past in the 90s. Frankly, I think it's very corrosive to the credibility to the U.S. Personally, and I think a lot of investors in the market would like them to pass the debt limit. If it's too late to pass a long-term fiscal reform, then we'll have to move that along. But we need to pass the debt limit right now.
Mm-hmm. And Ken, it's not just about what's happening with, say, sovereign debt, right? It's not just about the U.S. Treasury bond market.
Right.
Your strategic income fund is also outperforming its peers because you're not invested in treasuries. You're more heavily invested in corporate securities, specifically those that may not even be investment grade. So is that where investors should be putting their money? Not so much in treasuries, but more on the corporate side of the equation.
Well, regardless of whether they pass the debt limit or not, I would say that the valuation on treasuries is very poor. As you may recall, inflation currently is higher than most treasury yields. So investors are essentially earning a negative yield in most parts of the treasury market. Furthermore, even if they do pass the debt cap, frankly, the credit direction of the treasury is down. And typically, when credit deteriorates, you get paid more yield, not less. So from my perspective, I think corporate debt looks like a better alternative than U.S. Treasury debt currently.
Ken, it's John Ehrlichman. With your team, you have to sit around the table and think of the worst-case scenario. So are you right now of the belief that we'll see at least one of the credit rating agencies downgrade the U.S. credit rating?
I would say on the metrics, it's justified. Frankly, if you look at our debt to GDP, our budget deficit percentage is very high. And frankly, maybe one of the worst aspects of our financial condition is the unfunded liabilities we have due to our various entitlement programs, which are getting larger and larger. And when you look at that on a present value basis, it's nearly $60 trillion or more. And frankly, those three things in concert would argue for a debt downgrade to something like AA or even single A, perhaps.
So what are you doing then in anticipation that maybe that might play out? What are you doing?
Well, frankly, as I said earlier, we own very few treasuries in our portfolios. Corporate earnings are very strong, even though the U.S. economy isn't particularly strong. The overseas markets are pretty good. Revenues are rising. Cost cuts are still in place. Margins are high. Cash balances are high. Debt to ratios are falling. So from my perspective, I think the prospects of default is very low in on balance in the corporate sector.
Ken,
so
really,
why even deal with treasuries?
Ken, really quickly, some of your biggest holdings in your funds here are international, like French bonds or Canadian bonds. Is that a trend that you see continuing through the next few years here?
Well, frankly, a lot of other countries fundamentals and metrics look better than ours. Debt to GDP in Canada is lower than the U.S. If you look at a lot of the Scandinavian countries, particularly one we like, Norway, which we've held for some time, debt to GDP is very, very low, budget surpluses, and yields that are higher. So frankly, yes, that's an investment opportunity. I think that's very real and a good alternative.
Okay, Ken, thank you. Ken Talbs, the Chief Investment Officer at Pioneer Investments.